this is a much stronger Snow White than we've seen before. Is that something that attracted you to the role?
Yes, I definitely liked the fact that we still were doing Snow White, though. It wasn't this, we weren't capitalizing on something that everyone was going to have a connection to, and then making it sort of on trend in the way that right now girls are, you know, there's definitely a need for, like, strong females in movies, but right now I think that they're all, like, sort of, I've read a lot of scripts recently that the strong female lead is actually just sort of acting like a guy.
Okay.
And I loved Snow White's steady nature. I love that it wasn't about being strong. It wasn't about being excited about going to kill the queen. It was really about finding it in her to be able to. Mm-hmm. And you never see that in an action movie. It's always just like, yeah, kill!
Cool. And what kind of training did you have to do beforehand? Was it like horse fighting? Horse riding? Sword fighting?
Horse fighting. We did a lot of horse riding. Mm. I'm not a good rider.
Really? Not comfortable?
No. Not comfortable, yeah. Just so not in control, you know. I'd rather feed him apples and carrots and watch it.
You look like you're in control when you're galloping along the beach.
Well, I don't know how that's possible, but thank you. Thank you. It was a huge hurdle to jump over. I knew that I was not comfortable before I signed on to do the movie. Mm-hmm. And I like a bit of... This was not a bit of a challenge. This was like, I knew that when you watch that on screen, you were going to see, like, genuine fear. And I do like that. Rupert likes it, too. It's like, if you're actually feeling something, if you're actually in pain, or if you're actually freezing cold, it's much better than faking it on stage.
Yeah. And apparently, while you were in training, you accidentally punched Chris in the face.
Yes. Yeah. I love how you say that. Like,
he says,
don't believe me.
She was too on target for it to have been an accident. I was like, oh, okay.
He's still sobbing about it.
Yeah.
Like, it's been so long, Chris. Get over it.
What was your favorite scene to film?
Probably the... It's funny that I say this is my favorite because I was going nuts that day. Towards the very end of filming, we did the speech at the end before we go into battle. And we were so worried about it. I mean, it's like, obviously it's a pivotal moment in the movie. If it doesn't work, then the whole movie doesn't work. Mm-hmm. And we rewrote it every single day. I think me and Rupert had a copy of the speech in our back pocket every day of filming. And so once that was done, it was so epic. It was so, for me, I mean, I don't know, not claiming anything, I don't know how it comes across, whatever. I know that the actors get weird and insecure about, like, claiming anything, but, like, the feeling of it was why I wanted to do the movie. It was like, everything made sense to me that night.
You work with some great British actors as the dwarves. What were they like on set?
They were insane.
Really?
Yeah, like, I mean, all of those guys do a really good job at coming in to every project they do and, like, stealing the show. And now we've got 8 of them.
Yeah.
And they're all kind of, like, riffing off each other and really funny, but also really gruff. And they're scary. They're really, like, aggressive and... It was fun. It was fun, especially kind of trying to hold your own amongst all of that. Like, Snow White trying to find her voice hanging upside down amongst 8 of the greatest, you know, actors of our time. It was really, 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 really cool.